So now let's take a look at the major types of stroke of which we should be familiar. The word stroke is a general term and refers to an acute neurological impairment following interruption of blood supply to a specific area of tissue within the brain. Now, although immediate stroke care is vital for every patient, the point of this education is about reperfusion therapy for acute ischemic stroke. Now, there are two major types of stroke that we want to talk about. They are ischemic stroke, which accounts for almost 87% of all strokes and is usually caused by an embolism, which occludes an artery and affects the subsequent tissue of the brain that particular artery affected. The second is called hemorrhagic stroke. Now, this type accounts for close to 13% of the rest of the strokes and occurs when a blood vessel in the brain ruptures and bleeds into the surrounding tissue, causing damage. In the cases of suspected or confirmed hemorrhagic stroke, fibrinolytic therapy is contraindicated and the use of anticoagulants is to be avoided. Can you believe that 795,000 people have a new or recurrent stroke each year in the U.S.? Well, that's why stroke remains a leading cause of death in the U.S. And it's important to realize that early recognition and treatment of acute ischemic stroke is important because IV fibrinolytic treatment should be provided as soon as possible. So over the years, there's been significant improvements in stroke care because of the combined effort between public education, 911 dispatch, detection by EMS and triage, systematic hospital stroke protocol, and bettered management of stroke units. Now, there's been an increase of appropriate fibrinolytic therapy and overall stroke care has definitely improved. And in many cases, ACLS providers are well within the scope of being qualified to identify and manage the initial care of patients displaying acute stroke symptoms. In stroke cases, it's important to recognize that an ECG, though helpful, should not take priority over obtaining a computed tomography known commonly as the CT scan. Remember, there's no one arrhythmia specific for or related to stroke, but an ECG may help identify some evidence of a recent acute MI or arrhythmia such as atrial fibrillation, which could have been the cause of that embolic type stroke. Many stroke patients demonstrate arrhythmias, but if the patient's hemodynamically stable, treatment of such arrhythmias are not usually indicated. It's generally accepted and recommended to initiate and maintain cardiac monitoring during the first 24 hours of observation in patients who have experienced acute ischemic stroke in order to detect atrial fibrillation and other potentially life-threatening arrhythmias. This is important because the goal of stroke care is to minimize brain injury and maximize recovery. You see, the American Heart Association and the American Stroke Association have developed the stroke chain of survival and is similar to the chain of survival for sudden cardiac arrest. It correlates actions to be taken by patients, family members, and healthcare providers in order to maximize stroke recovery. The following are established links. The first link, rapid recognition and reaction to stroke warning signs. The second link, rapid EMS dispatch by calling 911. The third link, rapid EMS system transport and pre-arrival notification to the receiving hospital by the EMTs. The fourth, rapid diagnosis and treatment upon arrival to the appropriate hospital. Patients with acute ischemic stroke have what is referred to as time-dependent benefit for fibrinolytic therapy, which is similar to patients with an MI that demonstrates ST segment elevation. But in the case of stroke, this time-dependent benefit is much shorter. It's important to remember that the critical time period for administration of IV fibrinolytic therapies begins with the onset of symptoms. Critical time periods from hospital arrival are summarized now. Immediate general assessment should be 10 minutes. Immediate neurological assessment performed within 25 minutes, acquisition of CAT scan of the head to be within 25 minutes, while the interpretation of the CAT scan is completed within 45 minutes, administration of fibrinolytic therapy within 60 minutes from the time of emergency department arrival, and keep in mind that the administration of fibrinolytic therapy may be delivered in as much as 3 to 4.5 hours in some select patients, timed from onset of their symptoms. The administration of endovascular therapy should be 6 hours in selected patients, timed from onset of symptoms. And lastly, admission to a monitored bed should be within 3 hours.